All right, cool. We got the next checkpoint. And now we have this boss battle where we have to knock out these Bill Blasters without getting hit. Oh, and I smashed myself. Hey everyone, it's Darby from Blue Television Games. I've been getting more requests to showcase some of my levels, and since I have both new and old subscribers, I thought it'd be cool to showcase my top 10 most starred courses. Turns out that in rank number 10, there's a two-way tie, so it'll actually be a top 11. This is the first one. It's called New Super Mario Bros. U Inspired. Let's go ahead and get things started up. In this level, I was trying to recreate a 1-1 type level, based a bit on and inspired by the first level of New Super Mario Bros. U. So it's going to have a very traditional look and feel to it. Money moles are always sneaky little guys. There's little hidden secrets here and there. I do like the decorations of the level. It has a very traditional look to it. And I really did base it a lot on 1-1, like I said, of New Super Mario Bros. U. I try not to make this too hard so that a lot of people could get through it. It being a 1-1 type level, it might be slightly harder than a 1-1 type level, but not much. And here's our first warp pipe. If you have a mushroom or a propeller suit, you'll get a propeller suit there. But you can actually jump up here, I believe, yep, to get our first coin. And the coins act more like star coins in this. If you collect all three pink coins, you get a little bonus. There it is down there. You get 3 1-ups. Here's one in here you can only get by ground pounding. Awesome. The coin down here is super easy to get as long as you have the propeller suit. Just jump. As soon as you hit it, we'll jump up. That Goomba got me though, so sadly we lost our propeller suit. If you jump down here, you can actually go into another pipe. This area, you can get a lot of coins if you have the propeller suit like before. Even if you don't, you can get quite a few if you're willing to do some wall jumps and work for it. All right. Now we jump up here. We can collect a few more coins. And here we get another propeller suit. There are lots of power-ups, and I did that mostly for the reason that it's a 1-1 style level. I wanted it to be pretty easy to get through. That's a good way to get a lot of stars, making an easy level, because people like star levels they can beat. There we get all our 1-ups. Woo, and that Goomba almost got us. That's a poorly placed Goomba on my part. Once you get all that, you can go ahead and finish the level. I think this is a great course, and I'm actually glad that this one's got a lot of stars. I think it came out very nice. All right, in the two-way tie for 10th place, we have The Legend of Zelda. I don't remember this level at all, so I'm pretty curious to play this one. This is one of the first themed courses I made. I made a Triforce here. That actually looks pretty cool. I don't know if we get anything for jumping up here. It doesn't look like it. Although, gotta do that, right? Alright, there's something going on over there. I don't know. Let's go this way. Alright, so we got some piranha plants blocking our way. This was back before keys and stuff were around, so you had to be pretty creative with some of your puzzles. Alright, now we got a star, so we can actually go up through here, it looks like. Looks like we could have went to the right as well. I'm not sure what was over to the right. I believe in this, I was trying to make each section look like the actual original Zelda game, as far as little square patterns and everything. I think I did a good job of making it look like the original Zelda game. It's not much decorations, but I think for what I was going for, it works out pretty well. There's another power-up so we can become Link again. Alright, so we got a puzzle here, it looks like. We can get through here now. Alright, door. Now we can get through these coins. And we enter the pipe. And I just remembered the boss fight I made in this one, actually. And this, before I saw anyone else do this sort of thing, I actually did a P-Switch boss battle here where you had to wait for the P-Switch. That way it forced you to fight Bowser Jr. And this is the first time I ever saw anyone do it like this. I don't know if I was one of the first people to come up with it or not, but I definitely remember thinking this was a cool way to trick people, or not to trick people, but to hold people up so they would have to fight Bowser Jr. Alright, so we took out Bowser Jr. Obviously a key works better. I have it timed out pretty well though. We beat him pretty quick and the P-Switch just arrived. Now we can go through. So that was back before keys, back when we had to be creative with our boss battles. And there's the flagpole. So I think for an early effort, I did a decent job on this one. Definitely has a Zelda feel to it, and I did like how it looked like a Zelda dungeon as you went room to room. Could definitely use some improvement, but overall, I think it was a pretty good level. All right, up next, we actually have a music level. It's MGMT Kids. This is one of my better music levels. I'm kind of surprised it doesn't actually have more stars than this. I know a lot of people don't care for music levels. Let's go ahead and start it up. But I did think this one came out really cool. I like how in the first area, the music's simple, and then once you go to the sub area, it gets pretty more complex. Let's go ahead and do it. All right, and here's where it really takes off and gets cool. All right. And that completes the level. I gotta say, I really like the way this came out. I love how simple the first section is. It makes the second section sound really good. But I think it also hurts the level a little bit because I think some people will just hear the really simple first song and get kind of bored. People really like to play Mario more than watch or run. But I'm a fan of the music levels. I know how hard they are to create, and I think this one came out pretty good. All right, coming in at number 8, we have new update level BTG. Let's start it up. All right, here we go. It's actually surprising to me that this level has so many stars because it's really pretty difficult here at the beginning. I made the first section a little bit too hard. One of those things where I was playtesting, so it seemed easy to me, but it's really not that easy. All right. I guess I did it pretty easily, but I know a lot of people had trouble with that part. Alright, so this part we need to collect pink coins. More skewers. I think we can actually hit that with him, but I think we can also get a spring here too. So let's head up. Lots and lots of skewers. I don't like how I didn't take the one vine all the way up to the top of this screen there, but that's all right. I do like the crusher coming up from the bottom through the semi-solids over there, though. That's pretty cool. All right, well, we still need this last coin. And now we got all the coins. We can go through the locked door. There we go. Ooh, that's a lot of skewers. That looks really cool, though. That's probably my favorite part of this level. Ooh, okay, it's hard to get through there. I definitely made this challenging. I don't know if it matters which pipe you go down. We got a checkpoint. I am a big fan of this. I think skewers work really well with a slow auto-scroll. Just because it really forces you to dodge them. That's very cool. Definitely has a traditional Super Mario World Fortress feel to it. Lots of comments on this one. All right, now this part, I remember coins kind of help you know where to stand so you don't get crushed here. Hit those dry bones before they start throwing bones at you. Here's another section people got frustrated at. Those crushers in the lava are more just for looks than anything. If you fall down in there, you're gonna pretty much die anyways. And the same with the lava bubbles. Just, even though they can't hit you, sometimes having enemies like that just to add extra tension are cool. Ooh, we just found a secret. I don't remember this at all. Looks like if you find the secret, you get Yoshi. That's pretty cool. Where's the door take us? To the boss battle. And we lose Yoshi instantly. Alright, so we got a little moving platform boss battle. That's pretty cool. Definitely makes it feel kind of more like the original Iggy fight in Super Mario World. We got the key. We can go through the locked door. And we got a chain chomp type Blarg there, ready to attack us at the end. Just to give us something to kill with the axe there. Okay, so I think this one was a little unbalanced. I think the level should have got harder as it went. It felt like it almost got easier. But I do like some of the uses of skewers throughout it, and I like the auto-scrolling section. Probably my favorite part of it. All right, coming in at number 7, we have the Grinding Flaming Chain Chomp. Let's start it up. This was right after I learned how to stack enemies on tracks. I thought it'd be really cool to make a level with a giant chain chomp following you, a layered enemy, so he had a really cool, unique look to him. New Super Mario Bros. Style, you've always got to have some wall jumping sections. These type of levels are always tricky because it's a lot of trial and error. You got to keep starting from the beginning to see where the chain chomp guy will end up. I gotta say, I'm liking the decoration on this. I wish you could do invisible tracks. That would be really cool. But since you can, it is a little bit hard to get a good-looking track going. It always affects the design a little bit. That's pretty cool. So you hit that one up and it drops down there. Of course, I missed it. Looks like we can go up here as well. You make it up to this pipe, you get a little bonus area. It actually looks like the bonus room in the original Mario Bros. That's pretty cool. I even thought to make it to where you can't bust through those. And we get a fire flower. Cool. Might as well hit that checkpoint in case we die here. Alright, here comes the chain chomp, ready to attack us again. Cool. Fire flower definitely makes this easier. I remember I timed it out to where he gets really close right here. Once again, you can get a little one-up to come to you. Make it through the door just before you get hit. And now we have a boss battle. I don't remember this that well. I know you gotta find something to get to the muncher. Oh, you uncover question mark blocks by taking out the Goombas. That's really cool. Once again, this was before keys, I believe, so you need to get creative with your boss battles. Star. Can't get that, but we can take the chain chomp out. Alright, there's a POW block that was hidden behind the chain chomp. That's what we need. Take out the muncher, we can get the axe and finish the level. Cool. I definitely think that was a really cool boss battle. Probably one of the better ones I've made. I love the layering enemies on tracks. I think I did a pretty good job with it on this level. All right, coming in at number 6, we have the Legend of Zelda Labyrinth Theme. It's one of the first music levels I ever made and one of the first levels where I started messing with pixel art a lot. Let's go ahead and start it up. And I'll go ahead and I'll run through here and let you guys listen to it and tell you what I think about my creation. Alright, I remember that last little riff, if you want to call it that, was really hard to do, where it really gets fast and goes up. I tried to get as close as I could. I think I did a decent job. I think that heart looks really cool, like it's flashing. And I think the song sounded great. I'm a big fan of the original Legend of Zelda game, so that song definitely sticks with me. All right, coming in at number 5, we have Arcade Mario. I'm excited that this one's actually on the top 10 list. This is one of my favorite levels I've ever made. Let's go ahead and start it up. For this one, I used the Mystery Mushroom costume. It's actually the old school Arcade Mario. I made it silent so you could hear him walking, the little music, kind of like the old arcade game. I didn't want to mimic the original arcade game, so I tried to make my own little arcade-styled Mario game. And I just think this came together really nice. I like how you gotta ride up those platforms, and then you gotta come down these ones. After you get through each section, you have these little mini boss battles, which also has a very arcade feel to it. The Spinies and Clouds are great when they have wings because they shoot these spikes everywhere. With the auto-scrolling and the music, it just has a really unique feel to it. To me, it's just a lot of fun to run through here. I also like this design with the little bone semi-solids here and there. We got the checkpoint, which is great. And now we come back to another arcade section. This time we got to deal with Koopa Troopas instead of Goombas. Very similar to the first section. Alright, we made it up just fine. This is tricky. Definitely a lot of fun though. I can see why I like this level a lot. Alright, so this boss battle is supposed to be a little bit trickier. This time we have two guys to dodge. Oh, we already took a hit. I believe we get a power-up in this section at one point. Woo! Fire bars slow you down, which makes it harder to dodge everything. And we get killed. Yeah, go to the right, then go to the left. There we go. We definitely did better that time. Alright, so we have another arcade section. This time a mix of Goombas and Koopa Troopas. So I definitely like the vamp and difficulty here. Yeah, that's really cool. We have a door here. Do we want to go through the door or go through the pipe? The pipe's just spitting out coins. So we probably want to go through the door. Alright, and this also has a very arcade feel to it. Almost like a Donkey Kong kind of thing here. We gotta dodge all this stuff. I think the no music with the way Mario sounds when he walks, it definitely gives you that nostalgia. Alright, cool. We got the next checkpoint. And now we have this boss battle where we have to knock out these Bill Blasters without getting hit. Oh, and I smashed myself! Once again, this is back before keys, so we had to be a little creative with our boss fights. Alright, so this side's the side that we really need to break open some blocks on. Dodge this boss. Alright, one more hit and we can get the Bill Blaster to drop down. Woo, there we go. Bill Blaster gives us a star, so we can finally take out the boss. We can steal his cloud, ride up, and exit the level. Awesome. And here we hid the door right there behind a semi-solid, so it looks like he goes into the pipe to exit the level. It's a cool little way to finish it up, too. Definitely gotta say it's one of my favorite levels I've made. Alright, coming in at number 4, we have These Pipes Make No Sense. Let's start it up. Alright, this level uses the pipe trick, where you enter a pipe that you exited and it takes you to a brand new location. This is pretty much just a gimmick level that's a lot of fun. A lot of people seem to like this one. Let's go ahead and get started. So we enter the pipe, and we have this crazy, ridiculous stack of chain chomps coming at us, so we have no choice but to exit back through the pipe. But now we have a bunch of stuff ready to kill us and smash us, so we enter the pipe again. Oh crap, if we don't jump through the pipe, we're gonna die. And once again, we got a Thwomp ready to hit the P-switch and take us out. So we got to exit again. And here we have some blocks ready to smash us. No choice but to exit the pipe again. And here we have one of my worst nightmares on Mario. Way too many hammer bros. Let's exit the pipe again. And you gotta have a crazy stack of Bowsers coming at you, of course. Once you get through everything, you can get 3 1-ups. Finish the level. So this is just a gimmick level. It's a lot of fun. I do think it's really neat how you can do the pipe trick and kind of mess with people like that. But you can also use it to hide bonus areas and stuff, which is cool. All right, coming up next, we have Super Mario World Inspired. Let's go ahead and start it up. This is a level I made a while back before skewers were added. And I liked it so much, and a lot of people liked it, so I actually went back and remade it with skewers. And believe it or not, the original version had about the same exact number of stars as the new version, so I thought that was kind of cool. This one's very much inspired by the first fortress in Super Mario World. Although we can't climb on the fences here, we can still use them, kind of decorate. In the original level, I remember you could hit a P-switch, which made getting past one of the trickier sections a bit easier. And we reach our first checkpoint. I always put a hidden one up right there, almost always. Pretty funny. Alright, so originally this section I used thwomps since there was no skewers. Once skewers got released, I knew I had to remake the level with skewers because it just would work with the theme way better. This is supposed to be an easier fortress, so there's plenty of coins to guide you around. Once again, skewers, I feel like they work really well in slow auto-scrollers. Makes them a bit more intimidating and tricky. Alright, so we got plenty of power-ups here. Alright, and originally this boss battle, you had to wait for a P-switch. But I decided since keys were added, I'd go ahead and add a locked door instead. So this boss fight was reworked from the original version as well. Dang, taking 2 hits from Bowser Jr. here. And we died, that's not good. I'm really making this fight way harder than it needs to be. Alright, now we got the key, we can enter the door. Hit the axe and finish the level. Sadly, I didn't put anything at the end to knock into the lava there. I always like seeing something die at the end. That's a little disappointing. But overall, I think this is a really fun traditional level, and I'm actually still kind of surprised how many stars it's gotten, but it's definitely a pretty good level. All right, up next, we have Super Mario Maker. Let's go ahead and start it up. This is actually a playable music level I made, so I'll go ahead and let you check it out and listen. In this level, it has the theme song to Mario Maker, and you also built the level as you go, like Mario Maker should. So usually you can do that in 2 tries. Since I messed up, I had to do it in 3. Once you built the bridge, you can enter the next section. This section also features the next part of the song, which is cool. I wanted to make this a little challenging, but nothing too crazy. And here, for nostalgia purposes, I decided to do a little 1-1 part of the original level in the original Mario Bros. Here. Ooh, and we even have a bonus room. Woo-hoo! Oh crap, we lost our suit, but that's okay, we can still finish the level. I think that's a really cool playable music level. Definitely a lot of people seem to like this one at 598 stars, one of my most starred levels. Alright, coming in at number 1, we have Super Mario Bros. 2 Theme Run. This level has gotten over 800 stars. I've actually thought of messing with it a bit, maybe making it a playable music level, or just decorating it a bit better. This is the first music level I ever made, so it's not decorated all that well, but the song did come together really nicely. I had to change the key of the song from the original because it was hard to place everything where I wanted. Let's go ahead and check it out and see why this is my number 1 level. So the Super Mario Bros. 2 theme is definitely super nostalgic for me. I think that I did a great job of recreating it, and it's probably why a lot of people like this one. Even if you don't like music levels, it's hard to not like a level featuring the Mario Bros. 2 US version's theme song. Alright guys, well thanks for checking out my top 10 most starred levels. If you'd like to see my bottom 10 most starred levels, let me know. Maybe we could do that next time and try to figure out why they don't get as many stars as the others. Till next time, I'll see you around.